unto them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou hast sent me. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine, and all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are still in the world, and I come to thee, Holy Father. Keep through thy own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in my name, in your name, in thy name. And those that thou gavest me, I have kept, and none of them is lost, but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled.
Amen.
And now, come I to thee, and this is I speak in the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them thy word, and the world hated them, because they are not of the world. Even as I am not of the world, I pray not that thou should take them out of the world, but thou should keep them from the evil.
Amen.
That they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them, Father, through thy truth. Thy word is truth. As thou hast sent me into the world, even so have I sent them into the world. And for their sakes I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through faith. Amen?
Amen.
9. And the evil of hypocrisy. In Luke 11:39-52, and the Lord said unto him, now, do ye Pharisees make clean the outside of the cup and the platter, but your inward part is full of ravening and wickedness? Here the Lord admonishes us as leaders to be transparent in whatever we do. We must never be like the dreamers in leadership. We have our opinions and loyalties change often as the mood takes us, lest we lose the trust and the affection of those under us, as they can easily be led into destruction in pursuit of our own idle fantasies. Following Jesus is easy when life runs smoothly. Our true commitment to him is revealed during trials.
Yes.
Jesus assured us that trials will come to his followers.
Yes.
In John 16:33, discipleship never demands, or discipleship demands sacrifice, and Jesus never hid that cross. In Luke 9:57-62, three people seemed willing to follow Jesus. When Jesus questioned them further, their commitment was half-hearted at best. They failed to count the cost of following him. None was willing to take up his cross and crucify upon it his own interests. Therefore, Jesus appeared to dissuade them. How different from the typical gospel presentation. How many people will respond to an altar call that went this way? Time for altar call. Come, follow Jesus, and you may face the loss of friends, your family, your reputation, your career, and possibly your life. Come, it's altar call now. The number of false converts will likely decrease. Such a call is what Jesus meant when he said, take up your cross and follow me. Because nobody will come for altar call. Who wants to lose his job? Who wants to lose his mommy and daddy? Who wants to lose his life? Who wants to lose his iPhone? Because if you come for altar call, we'll take all your iPhone from you, which has substituted your diapers. or your your pacifier. So if you wonder, if you are ready to take up your cross, consider these questions. Are you willing to follow Jesus if it means missing some of your closest friends? Are you willing to follow Jesus if it means separation from your family? Are you willing to follow Jesus if it means the loss of your reputation? Are you willing to follow Jesus if it means losing your job? Are you willing to follow Jesus if it means losing your life? In some places of the world, such as Syria, these consequences are reality. They behead them, they cut off their head in China. Accept socialism or Jesus Christ and be dead. They say, okay, I prefer to die. And you kill them in thousands. Are you willing to die for Christ? Following Jesus doesn't necessarily mean all these things will happen to you. But are you willing to take up your cross? If there comes a point in your life where you are faced with a choice, Jesus or the comfort of this life, which one will you choose? Commitment to Christ means taking up your cross daily, giving up your hope, giving up your dreams, giving up your possessions, even your very life, if it needs be for the cause of Christ. Only if you are willing to take up your cross, may you be called his disciple. In Luke 14:27, the reward is worth the price. The reward is worth the price. Jesus followed his call of death to self. Take up your cross and follow me with the gift of life in Christ. For whosoever wants to save his life will lose it. But whosoever loses his life for me will find it. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Can we bow our head for prayer? Lord Jesus Christ, you call us to follow you as disciples. Help us, O Lord, to respond wholeheartedly without counting the cost. Lord Jesus Christ, you invite us to proclaim your gospel of hope and salvation here at home and to all nationals and people. Teach us, Father, to be faithful evangelists in word and in action. Lord Jesus Christ, you have given us every spiritual and material blessing. Show us how to share our gifts with others and inspire us always to follow your example of generous self-giving. Gracious Lord, teach us to give with a joyous and grateful heart that we may provide hope, consolation, and pastoral care to your people and thus give glory and honor to your holy name. We pray, Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
May God bless you, Lord.
Amen.